go, and we'll try to straighten it out. But I cannot tell you, express to you the frustration, the disappointment that I share or feel as a result of the conduct of people in connection with the events that primarily occurred on January the 7th and during the month of January in 2021. How do we regroup? How do we become a county again that's not referred to as crooked coffee? Because that's what I hear from people outside of this county. I don't want my county to be known like that. I love this county and I love the people. And I hope something that I can do will contribute to restoring this county and making it once again a place that we're all proud of. And I thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Introduction to Coalition for Good Governance and the work of Marilyn Marks and her team. Coalition for Good Governance works to protect Georgia voters and to ensure that votes are counted in the way voters intended. The interests of the Coalition for Good Governance are constitutional liberties and the individual rights of citizens, with emphasis on First Amendment rights, elections, government transparency and accountability, open records, open meetings, due process, and equal protection of laws.
Mr. Pearson, we know you're not like me. Well, like I say, my concern is the people who do not know me. Who do not know me. Because my mother, an honorable woman, who I got emails and texts from people telling me when I expressed what was going on my Facebook page, they said, we know what your mother stood for. We know she didn't raise you that way. But I'm wondering, how have you all been raised? Yes, I'm wondering today. I'm wondering today. Because somebody from the media should have had the decency to see the true facts so justice would be known and would prevail.
That's right.
This plaque, since you all say, recent altercation shines light on new militant organization. That's what y'all said. And I'm trying to find out where is this militant organization at. Because it's not us. It's not us. Some of us can barely walk. We are elderly. Walking with sticks. But we are militant. Because we state what is the truth. We're seeking to make the community better, which is what I said at that city council meeting when I announced that meeting on October 3rd. So how did militant organization come out of it? It's wrong. The meeting I had, Southern Rural Black Women, has been here in Douglas Coffee County since 1999. And I was asked to chair and lead this group. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. Not just justice for black people or black women, but it's geared toward women. Because women have had a difficult time finding daycare, someone to keep their kids so they can go to work, trying to finish and get a GED so they can get a good job. That's why this group was formed and has received federal monies and money from private groups to help people who are a part of this to better their lives. And you would take the meeting we held, which was held, hosted by Southern Rural Black Women, and distort the facts. Shame on you. Shame on you.
Yo, if I had 100 sheep and one of them got away, I would leave the 99 and go find that one. That's right.
Hundreds of thousands of voters have been struck from the voter rolls, and they have no idea. There's no question that this attack on the voter rolls is affecting voters of color and young people. Asian Americans, African Americans, Hispanic voters are being removed by the hundreds of thousands from the voter rolls of America. And this could absolutely change the outcome of the election. My name is Greg Pallas. I've been investigating the illegal purge of voters. Voter purge means removing voters from the voter rolls, canceling their right to vote. In the U.S., You have to register to vote. They cancel your registration. You're not voting. There's a good reason to remove voters from the voter rolls. You're dead. You've left your state or your city. You've been imprisoned for a felony crime. Okay, our problem is that our investigation found in just Georgia alone that nearly 200,000 voters were wrongly tagged as having moved from their home, dying, or being imprisoned. Their only crime, frankly, is voting while black. Atlanta, where one black person after another said, I went in to vote, and they said I couldn't vote anymore, including Martin Luther King's 92-year-old cousin. And what Georgia's done is say, these people have moved. They said that they got this information from our post office, which keeps track of who moves. But the Palace Investigative Fund, we talked to the post office. We hired their official licensees who said, we don't know where Georgia got this list. These people have not moved. So what they say is if Lydia Gonzalez registered with a middle name and she has a piece of ID that only has her middle initial, Lydia Gonzalez is going to lose her vote in Georgia. Not every state has this, only states that are afraid, frankly, of voters of color who have fewer pieces of ID, official ID in America. There's another game that they use. The state of Georgia and other states have used a system called interstate cross-check. They'll find thousands of people with your name, and they'll say, well, you've already registered in another state. There's a new gimmick being used by the Republican Party to remove voters of color. It's called use it or lose it. That is, you don't vote for one or two federal elections, and they send you a postcard saying, have you moved? Now, look, you can't lose your vote in America because you decide not to vote. We have the right to vote or not to vote. Well, if you're a student and you moved your dorm room, you're a renter and you've moved to a new apartment, you don't get your card, you lose your vote. That's un-American. Decision of the Supreme Court, and this purge method, removing voters you don't like, was taken for a test drive in Georgia. In November 2018, when Brian Kemp, the Republican, beat Stacey Abrams, a Democrat, the first African-American woman to ever run for governor of any United States state. The excuse for all this removal of voters is to stop fraudulent voters. You're removing literally hundreds of thousands of voters in a single state to prevent voter fraud. I'm not for voter fraud, people voting twice or dead people voting, but that doesn't happen. I actually calculated from the official U.S. statistics that the chance of your getting hit and killed by a lightning strike is 500% more likely than that you will commit voter fraud. Americans don't count. cast fraudulent ballots because you go to jail for 5 years. The purge of the voter rolls has been conducted mostly by voting officials who are Republicans. Because if you remove voters of color and young people, you're going to remove Democratic votes. Now, Democrats play these games too. But in general elections, it's the Republicans who are removing and blocking the votes of hundreds of thousands of voters of color and young people in several states, Georgia, Michigan, North Carolina, Arizona, and other states. What we mean by vote suppression is that someone's taken away your constitutional right to vote in America. It means that they've removed you from the voter rolls or otherwise blocked you from voting. Voter purging ain't just the only method that's used, you know, using voter ID laws, which block people from voting who are American citizens who otherwise have the right to vote. If you're an American voter, please check your registration right now. But there's also policy prescription. My God, why don't we just agree that every American citizen has the right to vote? And step out of the way. No more purges of voter rolls. Let Martin Luther King's cousin vote. Let Jasmine Bakhtiar, who's an American citizen immigrant, let her vote. Let Ashley Jones, a Latina, who was turned away from the polls in Georgia, let her vote. These are American citizens. I don't care who you vote for, but I do want every American to have the right to vote. That's our right. That's our democracy.
To send all of these college kids to jail.
Call our voter fraud hotline.
Governor Kemp has signed a controversial election bill. He signed Senate Bill 202.
That doesn't mean that you get to levy a charge against thousands of people that you don't even know and get them, you know, removed off the rolls.
Is this an attempt to remove a lot of Democrats, black people, from voting?
Get out of my house now.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
That was so good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm so tired. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Thank you, Lord.
You gotta rejoice in that.
Yes, yes, I thank you. I give all the glory to God and the praise. Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. We'll talk outside.
Okay, I'm gonna get my stuff from my car.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Okay, I'm here. Sorry.
All right.
Okay.
Y'all ain't no good. Y'all don't know what y'all doing.
Where you at? Stop laughing. Give me
they
some time.
They don't know what
y'all about the verdict, man. What do you think about the verdict?
Well, let me tell you about the verdict.
Be brief.
Okay, brief. The verdict was a foregone conclusion from the time that liars put together a lie to try to hurt a grandmother and try to hurt a black woman who has been representing her community for over 18 years. So it was a foregone conclusion when they came up with this trash. They spent our money on this mess for no reason at all, and we need to let the world know we're tired of them destroying poor people with this law thing they got. The law was why Jesus came, because these fools had taken the law and disturbed it to the point that it was as ridiculous as it was with this thing.
Thank you very much, Zach.
God
bless
you so
much. Thank you.
How you doing, folks? Andy Prati here with the 11 Alive Investigators. Let me tell you about a story that is starting to develop that we are working on right now. You may have heard about claims of voter suppression in Georgia and the Secretary of State's office getting sued for putting voter registrations on hold. Well, let me tell you about details about voter intimidation you may not have heard yet. I bet you haven't heard yet. It involves a grandmother in Georgia who almost went to prison for assisting a voter.
I know you before you started.
We go back a long way. We were next door neighbors.
She's not on this year's ballot, but it's easy to see why Olivia Coley Pearson has served 19 years on Douglas City Council, unopposed.
So we all go way back.
She knows her constituents.
Thank you, sweetie.
While popular in her district, Coley Pearson's toughest political battle happened last year. Not on city council.
You committed false swearing, did you?
No, sir.
But in a Coffee County courtroom facing felony charges. It started with a complaint filed with the Georgia Secretary of State's office. The claim, illegally assisting voters in 2012. Listen to an audio recording between a state investigator and a voter Coley Pearson helped.
Do you know why Ms. Pearson signed the back of the vote certificate that she was assisting you?
Because I didn't know what to do, what I ought to do.
Was that the first time using the machine?
Yeah, that was my first time.
At the end there, where you have to push the button to cast your ballot, who pushed that?
Me.
And that's what happened. That's what I was criminally charged for in terms of assisting a voter.
Were you on the ballot?
No.
Here we go again.
Reverend Rudolph Porter is a local pastor.
If she could have gone to prison for that, I guarantee you, you could serve all the hot dogs, the hamburgers, the Coca-Colas in the world. People wouldn't have gone to the polls ever again in this county. If she...
All rise.
Anybody else want to say anything?
Quit crying, girl.
Please.
We don't need some baloney.
Come on, you. God bless
you.
Jesus,
my God. My Most High God.
Praise God.
And he kept telling me he was going to bring me out. He kept telling me he was going to bring me out.
God is a God of his word.
Yes,
you just stand on him and do what's right.
All
Lord,
right.
I thank you today.
Yes, God bless
my
you.
My children can stop worrying about it.
Oh,
Lord,
Amen.
I thank you. I can spend time with my grandchildren in peace. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for all my supporters. Oh, Father, I thank you. This was nobody but God today. We had some righteous jurors today.
Yes.
We had some righteous folks up there.
What you going to say about your attorney? What about your attorney?
Oh, yes, my attorney.
What's your attorney?
My attorney, attorney Mark Loudon Brown, attorney Sarah Garrity, investigator Miles Shaduri, Hannah, and Kate. Everybody, I mean, everybody was awesome transporting people. I know Kate is tired. Cause she went to Douglas twice today.
Where's your hotel room?
Days in.
Days
y'all can
in.
Follow me. I don't know the street is on.
So who's going?
Sarah,
are we going?
Sarah, Maya. Get her.
What do you think about this verdict, my brother?
I love it.
That's all you love it? All
right.
That's Maya. That's Maya for the address. Right.
What do you think about the verdict?
Not guilty.
All right. What do you think about the verdict?
I think it was long overdue, not guilty.
Right.
We had to come to a whole nother county to get justice. We couldn't get justice in Coffin County. We had to come to a whole nother county to seek out justice because the people in our own county, who my mama helped and who she fight for, they don't see it. We had to come to a whole nother county to seek out justice, to seek out a not guilty verdict. We came, she came, she saw, she conquered, right here.
And let me ask you a question. And though the judge did not let the Get Through Free press into
the
courtroom.
He wouldn't allow the press to come in and see the truth be televised. He wouldn't allow it to come in.
And now that it's over, is there any news media here other than the Get Through Free press?
No.
So
news
do you
media.
Think there's a possibility
this
that they didn't want this?
They
didn't want this on 6 o'clock news. They didn't want this on 11 o'clock news. Can I say that?
You can say it, brother.
And it's a shame. It's a disgrace. A high profile case like this. And no news media here but the Ghetto Free Press. And then they got a lot of ugly names they want to call me. But I'm going to continue to keep you informed because you got a right to know.
Hey, brother,
isn't that right, Zach?
Yes, sir. You got a right to know it.
Uh-huh. Yo, if I had 100 sheep and one of them got away, I would leave the 99 and go find that one.
Look from the locks and jaws of Satan, I come creating, penetrating with force from the land of the lost and coming. Like Muhammad got the devil on the run. Rise like the sun, keep your eyes on the one.
It's on
the base, then to bring forth a reborn nation. Up against the norm, creating a new formation.
A new
this
dance.
Foundation that I be standing on is firm. Look, y'all, we must learn, or as a people, we gon' burn in the fire. Let's join hands with the Messiah, the Lamb be Elijah. For real, I ain't no liar, my deepest desire be to resurrect the carcass. Breathe like venom, then squeeze out all the venom with momentum and skill. We'll kill Satan at will. You and I be connected, protected by Ezekiel's will. For real, I can sense a mental explosion. On the move as God's chosen, proceeding in motion. We become, yes, indeed, the parts are forming. Running about a hurt, cause Babylon is falling. Living all in the midst of devilish anguish. His aim is to kill us all with this language. He's the mischief maker. Plus he's wicked by nature, the modern mind shaper. So hey, will Jacob wake up the lion? Wait, he's in Judah asleep. I wonder who will wake him, bring him to his feet. Speak now, or forever hold your peace. The violence of this beast must cease. Look out, I see a lion. Wait, he's in Judah asleep. I wonder who will wake him, bring him to his feet. Speak now, or forever hold your peace. The violence of this beast must cease. Now look for 4 days, he's been sleeping in the tomb. Fair like the zoom, no light, it's like the moon. His blood is be maroon, plus it covers the earth. Crucified daily, waiting this new birth. For real, the truth hurts the wicked evil to what he knows. That the future will bring a new ruler. So look, don't let him fool you with his maneuvers and wisdom. Seeking, you'll find that he uses symbolism with this rhythm. Black will represent the hesitant brains. Hit the water down the flames and sort out the remains. Everything must change, nothing stays the same. Our struggle's been ordained, so just chill, maintain. I know it's strange, but look, one came to raise us up. Farad has arrived, beware, don't self-destruct. Keep the focus, the red dragon's coming with the locust. Some don't notice, so they engage in shit that's bogus. But look like Moses, I'ma free you from your bondage, from those who oppress us.
wicked, evil, demonics. I promise that I'm a front, it's everywhere I go. My people gotta know, so I can't hold it in no more. For real, the pressure's on and that be the factor. We gotta resurrect quick if we expect to be hereafter. Look, I can see disaster, it's all in our midst. It's the shock of the hour, man, the clock be stuck on six. I wonder who can fix this problem from Zion. I'm in the wilderness trying to wake a dead lion. There's a lion where he's in Judah asleep. I wonder who will wake him, bring him to his feet. Speak now or forever hold your peace. The balance of this beast must cease. Look out, I see a lion where he's in Judah asleep. I wonder who will wake him, bring him to his feet. Speak now or forever hold your peace. The balance of this beast must cease. Now peep these bones as they lie, still dry in the valley, buried under rubbish. Darkness covers the body, there's no consciousness, there's no breathing, no pause. Walking dead in Israel, be that sheep that's lost. Guided by the false image, they don't know what sin is. In their forehead be a mark that reads crooked menace. It's continuous bleeding, therefore repentance is needed. Wickedness can be defeated when we submit, it's deleted. This beast be heated, he knows the fire's kindled.
We just know that the truth prevailed in this matter, and that God was able to do what man couldn't do, and he came out with the truth and set her free.
All right, thank
the
you
truth
so much.
Is what set her free.
Thank you.
From his very first year as Georgia's voting chief, Brian Kemp literally ordered armed seizures. He sent the Georgia Bureau of Investigation, Georgia's own version of the FBI, to Quitman, Georgia, to arrest 10 newly elected members of the school board. The first black members on the board, arresting teachers, including two PhDs. Kemp accused them of stuffing tampered ballots into mailboxes, that same old accusation as in 2000 Mules. Kemp had them paraded in handcuffs and orange suits like they were terrorists at Guantanamo. Local journalist George Boston Rhines has closely tracked the case.
I'm George Boston Rhines, and I'm in Quitman, Georgia. And I am immediately, just got down here. These are the Quitman 10. This is what I do.
After 4 years of prison over their heads, the Quitman 10 were acquitted of every charge.
So much stress was on those people. Lula Smart even considered taking her own life.
With all the indictment that I had, in my mind, I thought, well, if I just commit suicide, this will be over.
Another suffered from lupus.
Latasha Head, she died, and I interviewed her father, and he said that he believed that his daughter's death was a result of the stress and pressure brought about by Secretary of State Brian P. Kemp.
Rhines explained that the persecution of the Quitman 10 brought up traumatic memories of the lynching of 12 black men in 1918, what is called the Week of Terror. When Mary Turner raised her voice about the execution of her husband by vigilantes, they came after her.
Oh, wow.
Where are we? Can you tell me what we're about to do?
This is the old Brooks County Jail. This is where all of the equipment, and this is where all of the men that were arrested during that week of terror in May of 18 would have been housed in this jail before they was lynched. This is my first time ever coming into this place. I've heard some horror stories about this place. In May of 1918, Mary Turner was lynched. They took her, she was 9 months pregnant, turned her upside down, riddled her body with bullets. A white mob member took a hog knife, ripped over her abdomen, and out fell an 8-month-old fetus. And when that fetus fell to the ground, the white mob member took the heel of his boot and crushed. What do y'all think about the verdict today?
I am overjoyed.
And you gave a little short testimony, did you not?
Yes, character reference.
Yes, sir. And you said you're a retired captain.
Retired lieutenant colonel.
I knew that. I just wanted to hear it again for you.
And you all drove all the way over from where?
Brunswick.
Brunswick. And let me ask you another question, my beautiful sister over there. Why is it that there was no news media here? Do they not want the news published?
I have no idea.
I'm pretty sure they don't
want
to hear
about this. Oh, yeah, I'm here. All right.
I'm pretty sure they don't want to hear about this.
All right, y'all have a take care. Thank you so much. Good seeing y'all again.
God bless the racist city of Jessup.
Douglas, Coffee County, somebody said earlier, a lady said a few minutes ago that it's a shame they had to leave Coffee County to come to another county to try to get justice because they couldn't get it there in their own county.
Yeah.
Isn't that sad? Thank you so much.
Good night.
What's your name once again?
Bill McNutt.
And you served your country well, did you not?
I tried.
Name the wars you say in the conflicts you served in.
World War II.
Yes, sir.
Korea. Mm-hmm. And Vietnam.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for your service, my brother.
Sometimes we get our meals paid for by people that don't even know us.
What'd you say now? What'd you say?
If he wears his hat,
yeah.
Sometimes he gets his meals paid for.
Isn't that beautiful? All right, y'all take care now.
But everybody needs to check out George's videos on YouTube. Got it? You got it, George?
All right.
What's your name, attorney?
Mark.
I appreciate you, man.
I appreciate it.
What do you think about the case today, man?
I'm very happy. It's finally over.
Thank you.
That closing was out of the world,
well,
man.
Well, thank you. Yeah. Miss Garrity wrote a lot of it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she was over there writing. She was writing up a song. She was like, I've got to work on this. Right. You know, I was saying little stuff.
And you all go, I understand you all going someplace now?
Yes.
I'll be there.
To my hotel room.
Okay.
Hello.
Almost 2 years ago. Leave this dumb shit alone, okay? We cannot take a lie and make it the truth. What our problem is we believe in too many lies, mm-hmm. hoping that what happens is it change, because we do some dumb shit like pray, okay?
With all of that.
And all them people, Bishop McLaughlin and all that. They were out there praying. All the preachers going to pray. Cut my cock, I see my life.
They went to church after church. They went to the bishop.
Did y'all say what?
Yeah, man, don't do that.
That's what he did.
The bishop had a good friend. He got about 5,000 members, okay?
That's true.
Talking about it, what's his name?
Rudolph McKenzie.
That's right, McKenzie.
Is that the one, Little Smalls that was...
No, I say something. Jesse said, come on. And he told me, I filed this faces over to the 35.
No, girl.
This is what the law says. I've been through this many a time.
But you know what it happened is? He didn't mess around and let you in the courtroom the last time.
I walk you down the hallway.
Thank you, babe. I love you too.
Go ahead, bro. Come on, think what you're
doing. He said,
he said
his paper, right?
I ain't gonna forget. I'm just saying. Libby. She was there to help me out with selling dinners and stuff.
He still had his paper. I was walking down the hallway the last time. He's a good show, Michelle, too.
Yeah.
I said, I was walking down the hallway in the last time.
Yeah.
We went through this.
Yeah.
And this is the same thing. I did the same thing. But this is what the law said. That cracker guy's over there.
And you know something?
Here's what really got him. See, he thought he had brushed me off.
Let me come back a little
And
back.
I raised my hand.
That's right.
But see, I won't let it push me away like
that's
that.
Right. That's right.
When I raised my hand.
But see, that is at the heart of why you win. Mm-hmm. That you never, ever bend. Or give up.
That's right.
See,
you understand what I'm saying? That's what sets this apart
now,
yes.
from Coreen Brown shit.
Never give up.
Yeah. That's right.
What he did to you.
That's right.
He thought he embarrassed you.
That's right. That's right.
He embarrassed you, but you said wreck their patience. Okay? You said wreck their patience. You up with your little pad and your sister was there, you know what I'm saying? And that ate him, but you moved from the third seat.
Hey, you know you're watching that.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Bishop Brooks gonna watch everything.
When I saw the fools, I said right in front of Mr. Turner's face, too. When they were walking in the crowd, I said, y'all son of a bitch, just set y'all damn self up. And I said, y'all won that case, what?
But they did. I'm gonna tell you how they do it. I'm gonna tell you how they won that case.
Old Libby,
okay?
Old Libby, okay?
You remember what I said?
Hey,
old Libby. Remember when I said that you came out the line and they took?
That's right.
What happened was two things that they took and put as truth that was a lie. Okay. The first thing was them 13 things that you say they shouldn't have put in.
Uh-huh.
That shit was everything they
read. That was powerful.
Everything they read.
Those 13 was.
That's right.
That was good
when
stuff.
When they start talking about. They start talking about checklists missing, dates missing, signature not being in.
But they right. You done stayed on it. See, what your attorney at fence was, if it would have had to go to the appeal.
That's correct.
But it didn't have to go to the appeal.
That's correct.
What they felt
to
realize.
That's right.
If y'all listen to the shooting last night when they had the town hall meeting on CNN.
Yeah, that's right.
You cannot ask the person about their mental state.
That's correct.
You know what I'm saying? That's right. It's against the HIPAA law to ask somebody.
Well, see, listen. I work with people with disabilities, and I knew that.
You can't
ask them. That was one reason why I didn't feel like it was my responsibility to check them out.
It wasn't like the man.
It's not like the gun seller. It's not my business.
No, the man who sold the gun, he couldn't ask that young man, are you crazy? You got a mental problem?
You're right.
But the situation with you, but the situation. Olivia. The situation with you was totally different.
Mm-hmm.
They gave you a card to go and do the job.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the assistant director of the Board of Elections, he concurred.
That's
everything.
Correct.
He thought he was being smart on this side.
Uh-huh.
But he freed you.
I'm going to tell you something else. They did. That was absolutely stupid beyond repair.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Really.
Was to sit up there and have that damn fool have him read your testimony.
Yeah.
Me and this boy right here sit there when he did that. We went to grinning and kicking.
She didn't even have to take the thing. And they took everything.
They wanted
to
hear what you said.
Say something.
Yeah.
And they realized it was damaging the deal.
Even Martin said, Your Honor, I don't think, normally that's not how it
happens.
You know, usually. You just read what's there.
Can I throw something in? But I want y'all to listen to this part because I think this is really worth listening to.
Uh-huh.
Well, the judge said,
if the GBI didn't find nothing on him,
mm-hmm.
and if the Secretary of State didn't find nothing on him, well, why are we here today?
Before they did open argument, he said that.
Yeah.
The judge wouldn't know why they always said
I'm gonna tell you, that's right. He was complicit in that foolishness all the way to here. They were mad because of what happened in what you call him. His ass was just trying to do what Rump did. Rump did this.
Rump, who's Rump?
Trump.
Oh, Trump Rump.
His name is Rag. Because I know you went to college.
You went to.
One question I wish.
Listen. Go ahead.
One question that I wish the defense had asked the jury,
mm-hmm.
not expecting an answer.
Mm-hmm.
How many of you ladies and gentlemen needed help the first time you were confronted with a voting machine?
That was
to that defense.
Right.
Before they, when they questioned the jurors' vote.
That's right.
before you got there, Zach, they asked the question was, you was there the first time, mm-hmm. How many of you were voters? How many were non-voters? About, so what, 8 hands went up? Remember that?
Yeah, several hands went up.
Several hands went up, they don't vote.
No, don't vote, right.
The several hands, huh?
I missed the question.
No, you was out in the box.
He's saying once they picked, they got the jurors, that's something that they should have asked them just to make them think. But what Ian tried to do was use the analogy of a cell phone. A cell phone and a voting machine.
When the Robinson girl, she was very specific about what she said. Have you, you know how you said, oh, I had to get help
Everything that happened in this case was one, it started with a lie.
You cannot make a lie true.
Whenever you hold fast to the idea that lies will never succeed,
Now Robert Preston printed. The other three took pleas. Well, she decided to roll the dice and take it to trial. Well, first of all, she has a lot to lose if I was convicted or took a plea. They didn't have anything to lose, but now they got a criminal record, and she ain't got them. I ain't never had a criminal record, and I still don't have one. But you better
let your passion slow down for months. I'm going to tell you why. You're looking at a nigga.
You're looking at a nigga
who had to leave Brunswick, Georgia for years, okay, to let the whole action die down to come back.
Girls, no! That I am God, because some people doubt if there is a God. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you from the very beginning when I would cry to him and cry to him and cry to him.
We're gonna put you out of this.
Why? Why, Lord? Why? I said, Lord, you know I ain't getting that wrong.
The police coming here.
I said, Lord, you know I ain't getting that wrong. But that was his every time. Do not give up. You stay with me.
But I'm finna share something with you. Now the truth is honored. You can contest it.
You're
the honored. But it's still on your record. What you need to go to that courthouse and do, and file and get you some expungement
paper. I'm going to have my attorney.
And have him to get that thing. Because if you don't go and file and get it expunged, I don't care where you go. I don't care how much you've been exonerated. It's still on your record, okay?
Let me tell you one of the most positive things that we could think of, though. It has to do with the Southern Center for Human Rights. Mm-hmm. Don't forget. When we came to that courtroom and saw that trash that was in that courtroom in Douglas, mm-hmm. Who did we ask you to deal with?
I just can't remember. Southern Center for Human Rights.
We were the one that brought them into that.
And ACLU was there too,
ACLU though is different. Uh-huh. See, ACLU don't deal with nothing but constitutional issues.
Yeah.
They didn't have no constitutional issue in here. Okay. This was nothing but some crooked shit. Where they were trying to frame you.
Yeah.
And what happened with the Southern Center for Human Rights, I knew that the Southern Center for Human Rights.
You know, I got to get this, y'all, because that's very important what he just said.
Okay.
And very important. They need respect. Senator, that's good. That's very good what you did. Put your hat back on.
Get my hat, man. Throw me my hat.
That's very important what he said, because they deserve that.
Yes.
That's correct.
Those acronyms are powerful.
Yes,
yes sir.
Yes.
I want you to walk into this. That's good right there. Okay. Y'all may as well be quiet for a few minutes, okay? Zach, I know you're a veteran.
Yes, sir.
But I'm asking you this question because I was in the courtroom. No other news media was there.
That's correct.
But I really want you to say what I just heard you say it here, this group of us, celebrating the victory of this commissioner who God used to show Secretary of State Brian P. Kemp and the rest of those in the clique and among the slicks.
Yes, sir.
What God can do.
Yes, sir.
God just wanted to show them, just like all these other people that they brought up on charges,
bogus charges, I might add.
But you said something. I want you to say it again, and I want you to be, say it in your own words. Who represented this commissioner, and how did they get to Coffee County? Just start at the beginning and tell us if you call. Because if somebody is willing, if an organization, whether the NAACP is willing to stand up, but they need to be known. Come on with it.
Yes, sir. We have a relationship with the Southern Center for Human Rights. And that center is absolutely one of the only pathways to hope for justice in this state. The state of Georgia is absolutely vulgar in the way it treats its citizens in terms of justice. When we were first in the courtroom in Douglas, and we viewed the things that was happening in terms of her representation in that particular trial, we knew that we had just escaped by the skin of our teeth. So when the trial was over, the first thing we did was made a beeline and said, Southern Center for Human Rights, Sarah, Gerald, all them other folk up there with them bad people that on that little narrow street in Atlanta, Georgia, we needs us some help. I'm a Gullah Geechee. I crack out of teeth to play dumb to get smart, but I ain't stupid. We went running to Atlanta, and Atlanta come running to us. And today, because of the work that the Southern Center for Human Rights did in this case, it pointed the way to justice for a whole bunch of things happening in the state of Georgia.
Yes.
It wasn't the NAACP.
That's what I was about to say. Go ahead. Yes, sir. It wasn't the SCLC.
It wasn't SCLC.
It wasn't SNCC.
It wasn't SNCC.
It wasn't the Congressional Black Caucus.
No, sir. It wasn't the Congressional Black
Caucus. Wasn't Al Sharpton.
No, sir. It was this particular group of people who made a decision that they were going to take on this injustice, and they know they set the stage because the rumps of this world had made a decision that they were going to set up all of these cases through Brian Kemp and the Secretary of State's office and the Attorney General of Georgia, that what they were going to do is bring up all these fraudulent charges about voter registration for intimidation in the black community. And thank God for the Southern Center for Human Rights.
Woo! Yes. There it is! Yes. Woo! There it is!
That's what I'm talking about.
Thank you.
Miss Pearson, is there something you would like to say?
I just give God all the glory. I thank my team of attorneys, Southern Center for Human Rights. This lady took time out of her day on a Sunday.
Yes, ma'am, I remember that.
Going down to Florida. Where were you headed?
I can't remember.
But she called me and asked me if I'd meet with her on that Sunday morning, and we went and had dinner, lunch. And called me back a few days later, said, we'll represent you. We want to represent you if you'll let us. And I said, most definitely.
What?
And I tell you, I just thank God. God has been in this the whole time. The whole time. Because it was nobody but God that put them in my path. Nobody but God. Nobody but God. And my supporters to stand by me. I just give God all the glory. Thank all of y'all for what y'all have done.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Lalila, let me say one thing.
Yes, sir. Okay.
I want to give a special thanks and special recognition to the Magnuts, okay?
That's true.
Yes.
They have been with us.
Stand together.
These folks here.
Thank you.
No, for real.
You didn't do it. Thank you, Bill.
But I want to give a special thanks.
Yes, y'all did.
When we first introduced you to them.
Turn on this way, and they were to the meeting.
When we had first introduced the Magnuts to you.
Yes, sir.
Mayor Pro Tem. Okay. When she first saw you, Bill first saw you, heard your story, we had our gathering in Brunswick, she fell in love with you and she wanted to do any and everything. She worked the hell out of me for 3 days straight. 3 days straight, she worked the hell out of me. We got to go see that
But I'm going to tell you something else.
The testimony
of this colonel and that preacher.
Yes.
It sealed the honesty deal, okay?
It did.
And I'm going to tell you something. That little slick boy from Mark, when he used you as a grandmother up there, it was over.
Okay.
Mark comes from the best law school in this country, NYU, not Harvard,
Okay.
Not Michigan State.
No, Georgia, uh-huh. Hey, I went to Michigan.
Well, Michigan is one of those.
Don't mess up now. You're doing good. Well, don't mess up.
But the thing that happened in the state of Georgia, the crooks all come from the well, I can't say that number.
The University of Georgia.
Because Gerald told me that he went to the University of Georgia. So I got to clean up my act with that a little bit. But when you have the team that you have coming from other law schools from around the country, like NYU and Michigan,
yeah,
and maybe Harvard. I wouldn't trust Harvard myself, but Howard. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. When you come to these kind of law schools, you have a different mindset.
Yeah.
Georgia, the University of Georgia. If you ain't Gerald Weber. They have Confederate tint on how they view the law. Okay? It's just like Negroes and the Bible. They view the Bible through the theology of slavery, the master's way of you thinking and praising God. Okay? I don't teach that shit. I teach liberation theology. It's about freedom and nothing else. I don't care who you fuck.
They saw the truth. He said, how did they work that fast? They saw the truth. Those jurors, 12 jurors, came back out in about what? 10, 15 minutes? 30 minutes. However long. It wasn't long.
It wasn't 15. We know that. Definitely wasn't 15.
It was 35 hours.
Sir, we had three blacks on there. We had 11 women, one man. There were 11 women. And one man, three of those, three. Sarah? How long did it take the attorney to pick the jury?
Oh, it took a while.
She said it took a while, probably a couple hours. About a couple hours. Yeah, but they saw. When are they going to put it on the front page? Let's see. You wonder? A small little write-up, and it might probably not be going to be on the front page. I'd be surprised if it's on the front page.
Tell them all the news leaders there were to Get To Free Press.
Get To Free Press was here, and he's still here now with me. So,
I'm working on
it. Yes, yes. Attorney Garrity said she's working on getting it blown up and getting it out. That it was a not guilty verdict. Not guilty verdict. God is so good. Love you too. Thanks for calling. Bye-bye.
Okay, who else was there in the courtroom? You said, who was this? What other reporter was in the news? Was there?
She's a young girl.
From Valdosta. You saw. I thought you were walking out behind.
She works for the newspaper in Blackshear. Douglas, Georgia.
Okay. That's right.
She's 23 years old. And I told her, I said, what you write, they're going to go ahead and edit everything you said. They're going to put their own word.
Yeah, they're going to make her. They're gonna make
she's
her.
From Douglas, Georgia?
She's a young girl.
She works in Douglas. That newspaper.
Yeah, black
girl or white girl?
Black.
I don't know.
We do.
Oh, okay. What's her name? Well, call her name, my baby.
Oh, Tatiana Foster.
I don't know.
She's from Atlanta. She went to Valdosta State.
I did hear that there was a black young lady working at Douglas Enterprise from Atlanta.
So it's Douglas Enterprise that was there.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's give them credit then. Okay, that's good. Okay.
But they didn't recognize.
But they sent.
But there was no TV stations, all right?
No TV stations.
But let me tell you what they sent her for there for. For the hallelujah victory. If she'd have lost, that's what they sent.
Hey, sweetie. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah. I know so. Yeah. I ain't listening to that.
Because
that's
she didn't have the camera.
Not guilty. Not guilty.
I think so.
Call your Auntie Joanne.
You pray if you have your camera and everything.
Yeah, that's what we're.
I am so elated, though.
Greetings. This is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Boston Rhines, and I'm sitting with the most honorable winning person in the state of Georgia, considering what she has been through. And that is none other than
My name is Olivia Coley Pearson. I'm very tired.
Yes, she is tired, but I want to get this interview in. I want to talk with her because I was just outdone tonight in the courtroom here in Jessup, Wayne County. They moved the case from Coffee County over here. And it's so much I want to say, but I will not say because she is tired. But I want to thank her for this first interview. Nobody was going to get this interview but me.
Okay.
Because I have fought and been fighting from Madison, with the Madison 9 in Florida, all the way up through Clayton County, over to Warrington with George Ivy. And by the way, I'm banned in Toone Judicial Circuit by a judge over there. I'm going to talk about him a little later. But all the way back this way to Douglas and Homerville, Georgia. And so tonight, I don't want to take the pop out of this tonight. I'm going to get behind the camera, and the next person you're going to see and hear from is a person just like the Quitman 10 plus 2, the Madison, Florida 9, Meg's Mayor Linda Harris, Camilla Mayor Rufus Davis, former Mayor Lumpkin Charles Gibson. Look, I'm just going to quit there. what I want you to do is in a minute, I want you to talk to us.
Yes, sir.
All right.
I can do that. Okay. I can do that. No. I'm tired, but I can do that.
No.
Yo, if I had 100 sheep and one of them got away, I would leave the night.
In your own way, Commissioner.
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
Olivia Coley Pearson.
How long have you been going through with what you've been going through? And then tell us about the day. And I know it's a story in itself, but just be in your own way, express it the way you want to tell your story.
Yes, sir. In 2016, I received a letter from the Secretary of State, Mr. Brian P. Kemp, stating that an investigation was going on into the November 2012 election, and that I was one of the persons that they were investigating, myself and several others. Well, this has been going on ever since I got that letter in 2016. The ironic thing about getting that letter and going up to that hearing, what Secretary of State Kemp had written to me about, was that it was concerning the election of 2012. So I went up there, and he asked questions about a couple of people I had assisted. One was my aunt, one was another person I didn't know. Well, after I sat down, when I finished saying I didn't know one and knew the other, he stated that they would be sending it to the Attorney General, and I would just hear something. That was in March 2016, if I'm not mistaken. In May 2016, I received a letter from the Clerk of Court of Coffee County informing me that I had been indicted. Well, later after I got that news about the indictment, and that was about concerning the 2012 election, after I had gotten that about the indictment, I later learned that there was a warrant for my arrest concerning inappropriately assisting a voter and false swearing, two counts of each. So in March of 2017, we've been to court several times for hearings, motions, this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. Initially, I was represented by Attorney Julius Colling and Ms. Nefertara Clark. That trial ended in a mistrial, in March 2017. On that date of the mistrial, the prosecutor stated he was going to immediately retry my case. Now, mind you, this was not an allegation of murder, not an allegation of assault, aggravated assault, none of that. It was an allegation of improperly or inappropriately assisting a voter, which later we found out that there was no statute that actually applied to inappropriately assisting a voter. So finally, we kept on having motions and whatever. So another count ended up being dismissed. Two more counts ended up being dismissed. We got one of the counts dismissed at my initial trial in March 2017. Two counts, I'm sorry. One of the inappropriately assisting a voter and one of the false swearing. That was against my nephew. So that was dismissed, those two. So that left me with two counts. One, inappropriately assisting a voter, and one, false swearing. Well, I ended up having to get new legal representation. And the Southern Center for Human Rights contacted me and began to become my counsel. There, like I said, many motions were filed. Prior to this count right here, what I was tried on today, Southern Center for Human Rights were successful with getting one other case count dismissed, which was the inappropriate assistance of voter, where there was no OCGA statute that applied to it. Well, so now that brings us up to speed to approximately less than a month ago, I was informed by my attorney. If I'm not mistaken, on February the 3rd, my attorney emailed me saying that my case, because we applied for a change of venue. My attorneys wanted to have it tried in Lawrence County. The DA and my attorney both agreed to Lawrence County.
Do you know the district attorney's name?
Mr. Sansai, Ian Sansai. Yes, sir. So they both agreed to Lawrence, Dublin County, Dublin, Georgia, Lawrence County, excuse me. Well, we were under the impression, since my attorney and Mr. D.A. Sansai agreed to Lawrence County, that that's where it was going to be held. Lo and behold, when my attorney got some information from the judge stated to him that it was not going to be held in Dublin, Lawrence County. It was going to be held in Jessup, Georgia, Wayne County, where we are today. Couldn't understand why, but God. Anyway, my attorney filed motions to dismiss the last count of the false swearing, which the judge, you know, he did not agree. He denied the motions.
And what was his name?
Judge Andrew Spivey. Yes, sir. So anyway, we are here today. We are here today. And I can say, to God be the glory, because the jury that we had today, they voted unanimously not guilty. My God has showed up and showed out, because I had been praying, because I knew I had done no wrong. The young lady asked me, she said she didn't know how to vote. Could I show her? We went over to the poll workers. The young lady said she didn't know how to vote to the poll workers and that she wanted me to show her. The poll worker said, well, for me to show her, I had to sign a form for me to go over to her machine. Well, that was taken and blown all out of proportion, as if I had false sworn, because they say, when I say they, I'm referring to Mr. D.A. Sansai and his team. They say that the young lady didn't need any help because she was not illiterate and she was not disabled. I had no knowledge as to what the young lady was. All I knew was that she asked me, could I show her how to vote? And the poll worker said to go to the machine. I had to sign the form that I was going to over there. So anyway, long story short, this jury today, God put it in their hearts that what the truth really was. And to God be all the glory, because they came back with a unanimous not guilty verdict.
And that's where you stand tonight.
And that's where I am tonight, with a not guilty verdict.
Thank you so much. But there's a couple of things that I would like to help you, I mean, to share, to wrap this up. And that is that the district attorney's name is what?
Ian Sansai.
Okay, and he's aware that I've tried to get in the courtroom, and you are a witness that the first video, they did let me in the courtroom. Even they gave me a hard time on that, if you remember.
Yes, sir.
Because they say they didn't receive it. But then they let me record it, but I couldn't publish that mistrial video, right?
Right.
And then, of course, today he denied me again.
Yes.
But in between, when you was in court before, mm-hmm. he walked, Judge Spivey walked right past me.
Mm-hmm.
And I had already addressed it to the deputy sheriff.
Mm-hmm.
And he walked and didn't even acknowledge my request of the courtroom.
Right.
And my under Rule 22. Mm-hmm. I did the same thing today, and they denied me again. In my most humble opinion, he tried, in my opinion, mm-hmm. to embarrass me.
Mm-hmm.
And he can't do that because I stand on the truth.
Yes, sir.
And so, the final analysis, you are also aware that you are not the only one
mm-hmm.
in this maze of thing. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
You have heard me talk about the Madison, Florida
yes,
man.
Sir.
You've heard me talk about the Equipment 10 Plus 2. You went to some of those.
I
told you. Yeah.
I did.
In fact, you was in Thomasville
yes.
with Linda Harris when they removed her out of
yes,
you sure did.
Yes, yes.
And you have also heard about what's going on in Camilla with Rufus Davis.
Right.
And you also got in Gordon, Georgia, Mayor Ann Whoopaloo, she's been through a lot.
Yes, sir.
And so you know that this is a pattern.
Yes, sir.
You know that.
Yes, sir.
You know this is a practice.
Yes.
And you know that there's a system orchestrated, in my opinion, not yours,
mm-hmm.
in my opinion, from the top of Georgia government mm-hmm. all the way down to Florida.
Right.
And I got proof of that.
Yes, sir.
And so I want to commend you, and I want to commend the attorneys.
Yes.
And and as I sat there in the courtroom, I was prepared to stay tonight.
Yes, sir.
To do what I need to do.
Okay.
And I was surprised and disappointed
uh-huh.
that with all these paid professional TV stations
yes.
that they did not value what took place in the courtroom enough
yes.
to be there to witness this historic event.
Yes.
But I say to you, Commissioner
yes,
Colin Pearson, please don't feel hurt by the news media not being there.
Yes.
Because when they drop some 30 or 50 charges against Lula Smart in Brooks County.
Mm-hmm.
When the victory and the not guilty plea came in,
mm-hmm.
Dr. Nancy Denner, who is now the mayor of Equipment,
she
was one of the Equipment 10 Plus 2.
Right.
Lula Smart, since then, has become on the city council.
Okay.
Dr. Diane Thomas
uh-huh.
she now is on the Board of Education.
Really?
After Governor Sonny Nathan Deal yeah. removed her. And if whether you know it or not, there is a black majority now on the Quitman City Council, thanks to what the state of Georgia did
okay.
against those black people.
Yes.
And so I believe that this is all in God's plan.
Yes.
And people can say they don't believe in Jesus.
Right.
Or they can say they don't believe in God.
Mm-hmm.
But there are some of us who believe in a higher power.
Yes.
I don't care whether you call it karma. I don't care whether you call it a pillowcase.
Okay.
But in the final analysis, uh-huh. our grandparents.
Yes, sir.
And our great-grandparents.
Yes.
They knew the God
yes.
that granted this deliverance.
Yes,
they
sir.
Knew them. They
yes,
knew.
Sir.
And so regardless of what people say,
right.
we know that there is a God.
Oh, yes, there is. Because I can tell you, not meaning to cut you off, but you know when this first came about and there were three other people.
Oh, my God.
Actually,
please talk about that.
Actually, what has failed to be told is that there were five of us from Coffee County.
Oh.
There was a white gentleman, last name Woods. There was Mr. Hicks. Miss Griffin, Mr. Wooten, and myself. That's five people.
Right.
But for some reason, Mark Woods was not indicted, or whatever his name is. I'm not sure if it's Mark.
Right, but there were five of you, though.
There were five of us. Okay, so the Miss Griffin, Mr. Hicks, and Mr. Wooten ended up taking pleas
mm-hmm.
to the charges.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the Lord had spoke to me from the very beginning,
mm-hmm.
telling me that you have not done anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter what, don't you dare take a plea to something you're not guilty of.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just it was trying times because I was looking at possibly guilty, possibly prison time.
Prison time, right, prison time.
Yes, if I was found guilty. So it was definitely trying, but I could not leave the God of my conviction, knowing that I was innocent,
mm-hmm.
to take a plea.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't do it. And I'm glad that he spoke to me
mm-hmm.
time after time after time, and the times I cried saying, Lord, why am I going through this? Why me? I know I haven't done anything wrong. Lord, all I try to do is help people in
That's
this
right.
community
sure
when they
you?
Come to me for anything.
That's right. And you live in the footsteps of your mom out here.
And that's just how she was.
Yes, that's what I
She'll feed anybody came over to her house. They wanted something to eat.
Commissioner Coley, I mean, I don't want to drag this out, but
yes,
I got to say this because it touches me severely, and that is that when you was going through all of this, you had people as far away as Brunswick. You had people from Valdosta. You had people from just all around.
Atlanta.
From Atlanta, that's right.
You name it. Today, folk came from Clay County, Wilcox County, Daugherty County. We had a lady here with us today. She was even from Mississippi. Mm-hmm. One person was from Louisiana. Mm-hmm. The support was enormous. And I'm just glad that I was obedient to the Spirit of the Lord. And definitely folks from Coffee County who came out.
Absolutely. Now, let me close it out, but I want you to close out on this. I have a video.
Yes, sir.
That I cherish.
Okay.
That you did.
Okay.
I want you to talk about, and we're going to close out with this. You spoke in this video.
Yes, sir.
You said it like this. I don't be on city council for 15 years for the news media to do me the way they did you. You know, when they put out...
They said there was a group meeting to do something to white folks, a militant organization.
So they've been after you for a long time.
Yes, because that was in 2013, I think, or 14, when they published that. And that's when I began experiencing all kind of negative reactions from the district attorney, because there was an incident that they said that I should have been arrested for interfering with the police stop.
Which was
nothing. The sergeant on that case, as well as the GBI, said I did not interfere. The officer said, go to your car. I went to my car. But even after the sergeant and said that, the district attorney took it upon himself to send it to the GBI.
What's the name of that district attorney?
Same district attorney, Ian Sansai. And the GBI sent back, there was no wrongdoing on my part. So after that, next thing I know, I'm getting indicted about this.
I noticed you today. You started crying when the district attorney was doing why would you cry? I noticed you. Was it because of what he was saying didn't make sense? I mean, in your opinion.
Because he has done me so wrong.
That's why you were crying. I was crying
because I'm tired. He's done me wrong. I knew I hadn't done anything wrong. They never even spoke to the witness, Ms. Diana Robinson, until after they indicted me. They didn't talk to her then. The Secretary of State didn't even interview her. She was never spoken to. She learned about this case from the newspaper, according to some other people she told. She had to read about it in the newspaper to know that it was going on. So where did they get their information from that some crime had been committed?
Well, I'll tell you. Oh, the five people here in Coffee County.
Yes, sir.
Those five people, was they Democrats or Republicans?
The four pretty much known Democrats, and from what I was told, the one who never got indicted is a Republican. That's information.
I just thought I'd ask that.
That's information I was given. Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, look, I want to thank you for my time knowing you.
Yes, sir.
You are a warrior.
Yes, sir.
I believe that. And I promise you, I made three promises already and didn't keep any of them because that's the flavor of my nature when I'm dealing with strong black women.
Yes, sir.
And I'm embarrassed. I feel less than a man because wherever I go, it's the women that's standing up. We men folk,
yes,
we can't find us, and I feel hurt.
Yes,
Women have to beat the bushes by themselves. I'd be looking for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference.
Yes, sir.
I can't find them. I'd be looking for the NAACP. I can't find them. I'd be looking for Operation Push under Jesse Jackson.
Yes.
I can't find them. And I'm sorry, I'd be looking for National Action Network, Al Sharpton. I see him on MSNBC.
Yes.
I was waiting for him to come at Coffee County, but I haven't seen him.
Yes,
and so you know that the people that stood with you,
yes, sir,
are really the people that who you better look forward to in the future. Not necessarily these name brand people, because we know they just didn't come.
Right.
Okay. Yes, thank you so much.
And thank you.
What will you say to all these people who are going through being brought up on bogus charges? What would you say to them? Would you say to them, plea or go for the long haul?
I would say, if you know in your heart without a shadow of a doubt that you are innocent, do not take a plea, because in the long run, truth will stand and justice will prevail.
To God be the glory.
And we close on that note. This is Get On Free Press, George Boston Rhymes, and we report what others ignore. This is the flavor of my nature and the nature of my flavor. Isn't she a beautiful sister? All power and praise is due to our God. That's why it's good to praise the righteous and holy God. Bye-bye.
We Amen. Got
Commissioner Olivia Cole Pearson.
Yes, sir.
Before we start this interview, I was saddened when the verdict was reached today, and I think one of the local newspapers was there, but I didn't see the TV stations. So I'm going to ask you to be honest with me. We was in a group here a few minutes ago, and somebody said that you should not even do interviews with the television stations because it seemed as if though this your case didn't concern them. But I'm going to guess for you, if I may, and you can comment. I believe in the spirit of your mom, and I never met her, but I seen her picture. Mm-hmm. And I believe that you're going to be so mellow, so humble, and so fair as you wanted people to be by you, and that was not. And I believe that you're going to grant them an interview. Will you or will you not?
I will.
You will. I thought you will, and that's beautiful. Now let's get to our interview, because we do what we do, okay?
Yes,
we want to thank God for all of the newspapers and television stations, but look, we're going to do our thing now.
Okay.
Next up, Olivia Corey Pearson, we're going to do our thing, whether they come to her or not. Bye-bye. Commissioner Olivia Cole Pearson.
Yes, sir.
Before we start this interview, I was saddened when the verdict was reached today, and I think one of the local newspapers was there, but I didn't see the TV station. So I'm going to ask you to be honest with me. We was in a group here a few minutes ago, and somebody said that you should not even do interviews with the television stations, because it seemed as if though this your case didn't concern them. But I'm going to guess for you, if I may, and you can comment. I believe in the spirit of your mom, and I never met her, but I seen her picture.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that you're going to be so mellow, so humble, and so fair as you wanted people to be by you, and that was not. And I believe that you're going to grant them an interview. Will you or will you not?
I will.
You will. I thought you will. And that's beautiful. Now let's get to our interview, because we do what we do, okay?
Yes,
we want to thank God for all of the newspapers and television stations, but look, we're going to do our thing now.
Okay.
Next up, Olivia Corey Pearson, we're going to do our thing whether they come to her or not.
Hey, I'm a leader. Hey, I'm a leader. Hey, I'm a leader.
This is the Get To Free Press, and I'm George Foster Rhines, and I'm sitting with the most honorable winning person in the state of Georgia, considering what she has been through, and that is none other than...
My name is Olivia Coley Pearson. I'm very tired.
Yes, she is tired, but I want to get this interview in. I want to talk with her because I was just outdone tonight in the courtroom here in Jessup, Wayne County. They moved the case from Coffee County over here, and it's so much I want to say, but I will not say because she is tired. But I want to thank her for this first interview. Nobody was going to get this interview but me.
Okay.
Because I have fought and been fighting from Madison, with the Madison 9 in Florida, all the way up through Clayton County, over to Warrington with George Ivey. And by the way, I'm banned in Toon Judicial Circuit by a judge over there. I'm going to talk about him a little later. But all the way back this way to Douglas and Homerville, Georgia. And so tonight, I don't want to take the pop out of this tonight. I'm going to get behind the camera, and the next person you're going to see and hear from is a person just like the Quitman 10 plus 2, the Madison, Florida 9, Meg's Mayor Linda Harris, Camilla Mayor Rufus Davis, former Mayor Lumpkin Charles Gibson. Look, I'm just going to quit there. what I want you to do is in a minute, I want you to talk to us.
Yes, sir.
All right.
I can do that. Okay. I can do that. No. I'm tired, but I can do that.
No. In your own way, Commissioner.
Yes, sir.
What's your name?
Olivia Coley Pearson.
How long have you been going through with what you've been going through? And then tell us about the day. And I know it's a story in itself, but just be in your own way, express it the way you want to tell your story.
Yes, sir. In 2016, I received a letter from the Secretary of State, Mr. Brian P. Kemp, stating that an investigation was going on into the November 2012 election, and that I was one of the persons that they were investigating, myself and several others. Well, this has been going on ever since I got that letter in 2016. The ironic thing about getting that letter and going up to that hearing, what Secretary of State Kemp had written to me about, was that it was concerning the election of 2012. So I went up there, and he asked questions about a couple of people I had assisted. One was my aunt, one was another person I didn't know. Well, after I sat down, when I finished saying I didn't know one and knew the other, he stated that they would be sending it to the Attorney General, and I would just hear something. That was in March 2016, if I'm not mistaken. In May 2016, I received a letter from the Clerk of Court of Coffee County informing me that I had been indicted. Well, later after I got that news about the indictment, and that was about concerning the 2012 election, after I had gotten that about the indictment, I later learned that there was a warrant for my arrest concerning inappropriately assisting a voter and false swearing, two counts of each. So in March of 2017, we've been to court several times for hearings, motions, this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. Initially, I was represented by Attorney Julius Colling and Ms. Nefertara Clark. That trial ended in a mistrial. In a mistrial in March 2017. On that date of the mistrial, the prosecutor stated he was going to immediately retry my case. Now, mind you, this was not an allegation of murder, not an allegation of assault, aggravated assault, none of that. It was an allegation of improperly or inappropriately assisting a voter, which later we found out that there was no statute that actually applied to inappropriately assisting a voter. So finally, we kept on having motions and whatever. So another count ended up being dismissed. Two more counts ended up being dismissed. We got one of the counts dismissed at my initial trial in March 2017. Two counts, I'm sorry. One of the inappropriately assisting a voter and one of the false swearing. That was against my nephew. So that was dismissed, those two. So that left me with two counts. One, inappropriately assisting a voter, and one, false swearing. Well, I ended up having to get new legal representation. And the Southern Center for Human Rights contacted me and began to become my counsel. There, like I said, many motions were filed. Prior to this count right here, what I was tried on today, Southern Center for Human Rights were successful with getting one other case count dismissed, which was the inappropriate assistance of voter, where there was no OCGA statute that applied to it. Well, so now that brings us up to speed to approximately less than a month ago, I was informed by my attorney. If I'm not mistaken, on February 3rd, my attorney emailed me saying that my case, because we applied for a change of venue. My attorneys wanted to have it tried in Lawrence County. The DA and my attorney both agreed to Lawrence County.
Do you know the district attorney's name?
Mr. Sansai, Ian Sansai. Yes, sir. So they both agreed to Lawrence, Dublin County, Dublin, Georgia, Lawrence County, excuse me. Well, we were under the impression, since my attorney and Mr. D.A. Sansai agreed to Lawrence County, that that's where it was going to be held. Lo and behold, when my attorney got some information from the judge stated to him that it was not going to be held in Dublin, Lawrence County. It was going to be held in Jessup, Georgia, Wayne County, where we are today. Couldn't understand why, but God. Anyway, my attorney filed motions to dismiss the last count of the false swearing, which the judge, you know, he did not agree. He denied the motions.
And what was his name?
Judge Andrew Spivey. Yes, sir. So anyway, we are here today. We are here today. And I can say, to God be the glory, because the jury that we had today, they voted unanimously not guilty. My God has showed up and showed out, because I had been praying, because I knew I had done no wrong. The young lady asked me, she said she didn't know how to vote. Could I show her? We went over to the poll workers. The young lady said she didn't know how to vote to the poll workers and that she wanted me to show her. The poll worker said, well, for me to show her, I had to sign a form for me to go over to her machine. Well, that was taken and blown all out of proportion, as if I had false sworn, because they say, when I say they, I'm referring to Mr. D.A. Sansai and his team. They say that the young lady didn't need any help because she was not illiterate and she was not disabled. I had no knowledge as to what the young lady was. All I knew was that she asked me, could I show her how to vote? And the poll worker said to go to the machine. I had to sign the form that I was going to over there. So anyway, long story short, this jury today, God put it in their hearts what the truth really was. And to God be all the glory, because they came back with a unanimous not guilty verdict.
And that's where you stand tonight.
And that's where I am tonight, with a not guilty verdict.
Thank you so much. But there's a couple of things that I would like to help you, I mean, to share, to wrap this up. And that is that the district attorney's name is what?
Ian Sansai.
Okay, and he's aware that I've tried to get in the courtroom, and you are a witness that the first video, they did let me in the courtroom. Even they gave me a hard time on that, if you remember.
Yes, sir.
Because they say they didn't receive it. But then they let me record it, but I couldn't publish that mistrial video, right?
Right.
And then, of course, today he denied me again.
Yes.
But in between, when you was in court before,
mm-hmm.
he walked, Judge Spivey walked right past me.
Mm-hmm.
And I had already addressed it to the deputy sheriff.
Mm-hmm.
And he walked and didn't even acknowledge my request of the courtroom.
Right.
And my under Rule 22.
Mm-hmm.
I did the same thing today, and they denied me again. In my most humble opinion, he tried, in my opinion, mm-hmm. to embarrass me.
Mm-hmm.
And he can't do that because I stand on the truth.
Yes, sir.
And so, the final analysis, you are also aware that you are not the only one
mm-hmm.
in this maze of thing. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
You have heard me talk about the Madison, Florida
yes,
man.
Sir.
You've heard me talk about the Quitman 10 plus 2. You went to some of those.
I did.
Told you, yeah.
I did.
In fact, you was in Thomasville
yes.
with Linda Harris when they removed her
yes.
out of
yes.
You sure did.
Yes, yes.
And you have also heard about what's going on in Camilla with Rufus Davis.
Right.
And you also got in Gordon, Georgia. Mayor Ann Whoopaloo, she's been through a lot.
Yes, sir.
And so you know that this is a pattern.
Yes, sir.
You know that.
Yes, sir.
You know this is a practice.
Yes.
And you know that is a system orchestrated, in my opinion, not yours,
mm-hmm.
in my opinion, from the top of Georgia government mm-hmm. all the way down to Florida.
Right.
And I got proof of that.
Yes, sir.
And so I want to commend you, and I want to commend the attorneys.
Yes.
And as I sat there in the courtroom, I was prepared to stay tonight.
Yes, sir.
To do what I need to do.
Okay.
And I was surprised and disappointed
uh-huh.
that with all these paid professional TV stations
yes.
that they did not value what took place in the courtroom enough
yes.
to be there to witness this historic event.
Yes.
But I say to you, Commissioner
yes,
Colin Pearson, please don't feel hurt by the news media not being there.
Yes.
Because when they drop some 30 or 50 charges against Lula Smart in mm-hmm. Brooks County.
Mm-hmm.
When the victory and the not guilty plea came in,
mm-hmm.
Dr. Nancy Dennett, who is now the mayor of Quitman,
and she
was one of the Quitman 10 plus 2.
Right.
Lula Smart, since then, has become on the city council.
Okay.
Dr. Diane Thomas
uh-huh.
she now is on the Board of Education.
Really?
After Governor Sonny Nathan Deal removed her. And if whether you know it or not, there is a black majority now on the Quitman City Council, thanks to what the state of Georgia did
okay.
against those black people.
Yes.
And so I believe that this is all in God's plan.
Yes.
And people can say they don't believe in Jesus.
Right.
Or they can say they don't believe in God.
Mm-hmm.
But there are some of us who believe in a higher power.
Yes.
I don't care whether you call it karma. I don't care whether you call it a pillowcase.
Okay.
But in the final analysis, uh-huh. our grandparents.
Yes, sir.
And our great-grandparents.
Yes.
They knew the God
yes.
that granted this deliverance.
Yes,
they
sir.
Knew them. They
yes,
knew.
Sir.
And so regardless of what people say,
right.
we know that there is a God.
Oh, yes, there is. Because I can tell you, not meaning to cut you off, but you know when this first came about and there were three other people.
Oh, my God. Actually, please talk about that.
Actually, what has failed to been told is that there were five of us from Coffee County.
Oh.
There was a white gentleman, last name Woods. Okay. There was Mr. Hicks. Miss Griffin, Mr. Wooten, and myself.
Mm-hmm.
That's five people.
Right.
But for some reason, Mark Woods was not indicted, or whatever his name is. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if it's Mark.
Right, but there were five of you, though.
There were five of us. Okay, so the Miss Griffin, Mr. Hicks, and Mr. Wooten ended up taking pleas
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
to the charges.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the Lord had spoke to me from the very beginning,
mm-hmm.
telling me that you have not done anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter what, don't you dare take a plea to something you're not guilty of.
Mm-hmm.
And it was it was trying times because I was looking at possibly guilty. Possibly prison time.
Prison time, right? Prison time.
Yes, if I was found guilty. So it was definitely trying, but I could not leave the God of my conviction, knowing that I was innocent,
mm-hmm.
to take a plea.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't do it. And I'm glad that he spoke to me time after time after time, and the times I cried saying, Lord, why am I going through this? Why me? I know I haven't done anything wrong. Lord, all I try to do is help people in
That's
this
right.
community
sure
when they
you?
Come to me for anything.
That's right. And you live in the footsteps of your mom out here.
and that's just how she
yes.
was.
Yes, that's what I
She'll feed anybody came over to her right. house. Right. They wanted something to eat.
Commissioner Coley, I mean, I don't want to drag this out, but
yes,
I got to say this because it touches me severely, and that is that when you was going through all of this, you had people as far away as Brunswick. You had people from Valdosta. You had people from just all around.
Atlanta.
From Atlanta, that's right.
You name it. Today, folk came from Clay County, Wilcox County, Daugherty County. We had a lady here with us today. She was even from Mississippi. Mm-hmm. One person was from Louisiana. Mm-hmm. The support was enormous. And I'm just glad that I was obedient to the Spirit of the Lord. And definitely folks from Coffee County who came out.
Absolutely. Now, let me close it out, but I want you to close out on this. I have a video.
Yes, sir.
That I cherish.
Okay.
That you did.
Okay.
I want you to talk about, and we're going to close out with this. You spoke in this video.
Yes, sir.
You said it like this. I don't be on city council for 15 years for the news media to do me the way they did you. You know, when they put out...
When they put something in the
many
paper,
of you all, many of you all
they said that there was
meeting.
A group meeting to do something to white folks, a militant organization.
So they've been after you for a long time.
Yes, yes, because that was in 2013, I think, or 14, when they published that. And that's when I began experiencing all kind of negative reactions from the district attorney, because there was an incident that they said that I should have been arrested for interfering with the police stop.
Which was
nothing. The sergeant on that case, as well as the GBI, said I did not interfere. The officer said, go to your car. I went to my car. But even after the sergeant and said that, the district attorney took it upon himself to send it to the GBI.
What's the name of that district attorney?
Same district attorney, Ian Sansai. And the GBI sent back. There was no wrongdoing on my part. So after that, next thing I know, I'm getting indicted about this.
I noticed you today. You started crying when the district attorney was doing what? Why were you crying? I noticed you. Was it because of what he was saying didn't make sense? I mean, in your opinion.
Because he has done me so wrong.
That's why you were crying. I noticed
that. I was crying
that.
Because I'm tired. He's done me wrong. I knew I hadn't done anything wrong. They never even spoke to the witness, Ms. Diana Robinson, until after they indicted me. They didn't talk to her then. The Secretary of State didn't even interview her. She was never spoken to. She learned about this case from the newspaper, according to some other people she told. She had to read about it in the newspaper to know that it was going on. So where did they get their information from that some crime had been committed?
Well, I'll tell you. Oh, the five people here in Coffee County.
Yes, sir.
Those five people, was they Democrats or Republicans?
The four pretty much known Democrats, and from what I was told, the one who never got indicted is a Republican. That's information.
I just thought I'd ask that.
That's information
I was
given.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, look, I want to thank you for my time knowing you.
Yes, sir.
You are a warrior.
Yes, sir.
I believe that. And I promise you, I made three promises already and didn't keep any of them because that's the flavor of my nature when I'm dealing with strong black women.
Yes, sir.
And I'm embarrassed. I feel less than a man because wherever I go, it's the women that's standing up. We
yes,
men
sir.
Folk,
yes,
we can't find us, and I feel hurt.
Yes, sir.
Women have to beat the bushes by themselves. I'd be looking for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference.
Yes, sir.
I can't find them. I'd be looking for the NAACP. I can't find them. I'd be looking for Operation Push under Jesse Jackson.
Yes.
I can't find them. And I'm sorry, I'd be looking for National Action Network, Al Sharpton. I see him on MSNBC.
Yes.
I was waiting for him to come at Coffee County, but I haven't seen him.
Yes,
and so you know that the people that stood with you
yes,
are really the people that who you better look forward to in the future. Not necessarily these name brand people, because we know they just didn't come.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What will you say to all these people who are going through being brought up on bogus charges? What would you say to them? Would you say to them, plea or go for the long haul?
I would say, if you know in your heart, without a shadow of a doubt, that you are innocent, do not take a plea, because in the long run, truth will stand and justice will prevail. To God be the glory.
And we close on that note. This is the Ghetto Free Press, George Boston Lines, and we report what others ignore.
Decided not to answer any questions. That was Mr. Harris answering y'all's questions, so I respect y'all not to ask me any questions as well. Just stick to your statement and be done with that. So we're not going to answer any questions because of fear of manipulation. So with that said, I'm going to introduce Ms. Olivia Pearson, City Commission.
Thank you, Mr. Again, thank you, Mr. Worthy. To begin, I'm going to fall back on something that Mr. Presley mentioned. He said that you stated that it had nothing to do with the group. Well, I'm not sure that you stated it didn't have anything to do with the group. I know just a minute ago, Jerry Hudson said it was mainly on Douglas Now, it was mainly about Bobby Worthy.
His article was?
Not quite. Supported by Commissioner Pearson. That's what he stated, which was a total lie because I had nothing to do with Bobby Worthy and Larry Neesmith. That was totally separable from this whole thing that you all have blown to hell because that's what you've done.
His name wasn't on that flyer for it, for the meeting, as a supporter?
Who held the meeting? You asked me a question. I'm asking you, who held the meeting?
I did, and he didn't answer it. Wasn't your name on that flyer?
I held the meeting. Sure, my name would be on it.
Okay, well,
see, that's where you went wrong.
That's all we said.
No. That's not all you said. You said supported by Commissioner Pearson. What was supported by Commissioner Pearson?
The meeting
that I called, that's exactly right. I called the meeting. Justice League did not call the meeting, first and foremost. They didn't call the meeting. I held a meeting through Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. I invited Mr. Bobby Worthy and the NAACP. Let me finish, Mr. Hudson.
That was before the article, the mention of you.
No. You claim that the Justice League held this meeting, which was a lie. It was a lie. You said it, as well as the Douglas Enterprise said it. Justice League did not hold a meeting here in Douglas, Georgia. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative held a meeting. I invited Mr. Worthy. I invited Ms. O'Hara as district rep for the NAACP. I invited Mr. Hal Presley. And matter of fact, I invited the entire community of the city of Douglas, Coffee County, Georgia. I announced it on my city council meeting. So why in the world, tell me, would I hold a meeting that's going to succumb to or support hatred towards white people or any other people, why would I hold a public announcement of a meeting like that? I haven't been in office for 15 years to do something so low down and dirty. See, you had your facts, you had your statements incorrect. Had you all given us the respect and decency to come and ask a question. Ed, you were at the meeting when I announced about that flyer. If you had a concern or an issue about it being to hate white folks or kill white folks, seemed like to me you would have had the courtesy, being that you were there, to have came to me, Commissioner Pearson, what is this about? But no, not one of you, journalism fellas or lady, I'm not sure what part you played in it. So if you did play a part, excuse that comment. Not one of you had the decency or respect to come to me as an elected official and ask the question, what is this all about? A decent journalist who is seeking the truth has a moral and ethical obligation to go and
get both sides of a story and not just print one side and not just assume. And none of you did that. So yes, I feel my life is threatened with something like this. And you sat there when Mr. Presley asked the question, have you gotten any feedback from anybody? Nobody would say anything. You didn't answer it. But I already know the answer to it. You've gotten feedback because I've gotten feedback. I've gotten feedback from white people. I've got feedback from black people. And they're not satisfied with it, black or white. And they have all said to me, Olivia, we know that's not true. So some people who might not know me might not know, but those who know me know I wouldn't take part in anything that's going to deal with hatred or killing or anything in breaking the law. So on now today, you all want to come and be a part of this press release, this news conference on today, after you have done your damage. Because like I said, damage has been done. Because don't everybody know all of us and what we stand for. It's just the grace of God that those who do know us know we wouldn't dare partake of any such foolishness.
Amen.
And I feel like what you're doing is displaying what you have in your heart.
Amen.
To print something like this.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I can say to you,
yes.
I can say to you, not one of you have ever had me to say anything racist to you, to say anything about hatred to you, in dealing with your media and dealing with me. None of you can say that I've ever said anything racist.
Right.
If it's right, if it's a fact about what has happened, and it might tend to lean on one side of the color line or the other, call it what you may. But God be my judge. He knows my heart. And no, I wouldn't partake of anything such as this that you all have intended to influence this community to believe.
Amen.
That's
right. It's totally unacceptable, and
we are not going to tolerate it.
Mm-hmm.
So now you want to go and dig and talk about the use of the Coley Center. Get the records about the Coley Center. You dig on and see what you find. If anybody got any money for using the Coley Center, it definitely was not Commissioner Olivia Coley Pearson.
Right.
I have never used the Coley Center or any facility of the City of Douglas in an inappropriate manner. That's why I announced the meeting of that we were having on October 3rd. That's why I announced it at my city council meeting. And I said then, anybody who is concerned about community and would like to help and take part, please come. That was my request. But you all are tending to try to divide this community more and more and more. I'm concerned as to who employs the Douglas 9 employees, as well as the Douglas Enterprise. What do these people stand for? I'm really surprised at this time. I'm surprised because your editors should have told you, go get the other side, see what they have to say about it before we print this.
Should have been fact checked.
It should have been.
Should have been fact checked.
And it's sad. It's sad because it's too late in the day with too much everything that's going on in our surroundings and our communities and our different states. It's too much and too late in the day to try to print something like this to make white folk feel that they need to go and buy guns, which was announced at a church meeting by a white lady that she needs to go and buy a gun because of this group that has been formed. And I suggest to the rest of y'all that y'all go by one is what she was quoted as saying. So if it's in y'all's heart to cause this kind of deliberate tension and division, you need to go check yourselves.
They damage the community.
You need to go check yourselves. God is not pleased. God is not pleased. When I chose to run for office, I found all kind of opposition. Some by black folks, but some by white folks. And ever since I've been in office, I've had to deal with you all saying statements that were not true, trying to blemish my name. So whatever it is you're seeking, I hope you find it. But I can tell you, my name is not going to be blemished because the people know what I stand for. When I talk to the white city employees, Commissioner Pearson, we know you're not like that. But like I say, my concern is the people who do not know me. Amen. Who do not know me.
Amen.
Because my mother, an honorable woman, who I got emails and texts from people telling me when I expressed what was going on my Facebook page, they said, we know what your mother stood for. We know she didn't raise you that way. Mm-hmm. But I'm wondering, how have you all been raised? Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm wondering today.
Right.
I'm wondering today. Because somebody from the media should have had the decency to see the true facts, so justice would be known and would prevail.
That's right.
This plaque, since you all say recent altercation shines light on new militant organization, that's what y'all said. That's what y'all said. And I'm trying to find out, where is this militant organization at? Because it's not us. It's not us. Some of us can barely walk. We are elderly, walking with sticks, but we are militant because we state what is the truth. We're seeking to make the community better, which is what I said at that city council meeting when I announced that meeting on October 3rd. So how did militant organizations come out of it? It's wrong. The meeting I had, Southern Rural Black Women, has been here in Douglas Coffee County since 1999. And I was asked to chair and lead this group. Southern Rural Black Women's Initiative for Economic and Social Justice. Not just justice for black people or black women, but it's geared toward women, because women have had a difficult time finding daycare, someone to keep their kids so they can go to work, trying to finish and get a GED so they can get a good job. That's why this group was formed and has received federal monies and money from private groups to help people who are a part of this to better their lives. And you would take the meeting we held, which was held, hosted by Southern Rural